I'm Calyn Thompson here at the Digital Desk, and joining us today is Chaunte Lowe, a Olympian and breast cancer thriver. Chaunte, thank you for joining us today. When you were in the midst of your battle going through chemo, you were actually training for the Olympics. What was that like? Talk about maybe your struggles and mental toughness piece there.
Yeah, so actually the cancer diagnosis came first. And through that cancer diagnosis, I started becoming aware of statistics specifically surrounding breast cancer, that 1 in 8 women in their lifetime in the U.S. will be diagnosed with breast cancer, that African-American women are dying of breast cancer at a 40% higher rate than our white woman counterparts. And I realized that men get breast cancer. And so becoming aware of those statistics, I wanted to do something. I wanted to join in the fight on behalf of those people. And the best way that I knew how was to jump and to jump high. And I realized that if I can get back to the Olympic Games, I can get in front of the cameras and the audiences and share my story. And hopefully one woman or man would get checked. Maybe somebody would be inspired to fund research. And that's just what I had. And so I was giving it my best effort because I wanted to be a part of the solution.
Yeah, it's such a personal journey, but you decided to make it public and share your story. What was that like?
Emotional. Just being able to be transparent and vulnerable about everything that I was going through. But I felt empowered at the same time because I knew that other people were going through it too. And immediately when I was diagnosed, I felt alone. I felt like there was nobody else experiencing what I was experiencing. And then when I realized that there were other people experiencing it, I wanted to be vulnerable and show them visibly that they weren't alone. And so I would go online when I had to shave my head, when my hair started falling out. I made that very public. I shared the shedding fingernails. I updated about the double mastectomy that I had and the chemotherapy treatments. But I kept getting these messages of hope from other people saying, thank you for sharing my story. Or I constantly, even to this day, get messages from people who share that they are newly diagnosed. And it's put me in a position to be able to share my experience and give them that support one-on-one. But also, you know, for people that might be too shy to ask questions, they can go online on my Instagram page and kind of get some of that information.
Sure. I was watching your TED Talk, and I think you used the word responsibility. Can you talk to me about that, about what you felt?
I know sometimes that athletes say that they're not role models or that they don't have that responsibility, but I kind of take a different spin that if the cameras are on me and if I would have wanted that same type of support in my life, then it is my responsibility to give that support to somebody else. And so I do take it very seriously, especially the mother of daughters and, you know, knowing that the statistics make it that I want to make the world better so that by time they're my age or, you know, they will not have to face this. And so that's why I fight so hard, because I feel like a responsibility towards my community, but also a responsibility towards my own children.
Sure. Chaunte, how did cancer change you?
That's a very, very good question. Cancer changed me in every single way possible. I just celebrated my 40th birthday, and instead of being like, wow, oh no, I'm old, and I was so thankful that I've lived to see my 40th birthday. And I understand that the small stuff is not something I need to sweat every day. Instead, looking at the overall picture as a whole, it's allowed me to become more patient and understanding in my role as a mother, but also as an advocate. And I don't take any moment for granted. I feel like every single day is a blessing, and I live it to the fullest, but I want to be responsible, there's that word again, with every single day and make sure every single day of my life counts because I fought for this life.
Sure. At Rally Against Cancer coming up, there might be people in the audience who just got a new diagnosis or in the middle of their own cancer journey. Do you have any words of wisdom for them?
One of the first things that I did when I got my diagnosis is I went online and started looking at the success stories of people who had faced the same type of cancer that I have and are living to this day. And I know that success looks different. There are many people that are living with cancer and will continue to live that way for the rest of their lives. but the quality of life is so different. The research is so hopeful, the amount of support and people becoming aware of this fight and deciding to join arms with us, lock arms and get into the fight with us, it is hopeful. So no matter what, no matter how hard the day is, do not give up hope, but give yourself the grace to feel the feelings that you feel. Surround yourself with people, organizations, and communities that will help support you and help you navigate these feelings. But no matter what, know that the sacrifice that you're making right now, whatever treatment option, whatever you have to do, is well worth the fight. And know that that you have the right to hope. And so never give up on that.
Sure. You mentioned the word support. What message would you give for family members or caregivers who are walking alongside cancer fighters?
Just as important for you to put the oxygen mask on yourself as well. I think that I've talked to a lot of supporters, and you know, I even watched my husband firsthand when I was going through my surgeries and my treatment. He was my caregiver, and I could see that he would put on such a brave face for me, but I know that there were moments where he went by himself and he cried, or he had his moment where he needed other people to uplift him. So it's so important for you to take that time for yourself. Re-energize, refuel, make sure that you're filling yourself up so that you could be there for the person that you're caring for. So your care, your self-care is just as important as the amount of attention that you put into the person that you're caring for.
Sure. When people walk away from your speech, from your message, what feeling do you want them to have?
You to have hope. After you hear me speak, I'm going to be sharing my story. I'm going to make it humorous. We're going to laugh. We're going to have a good time, but we're also going to touch on some of the most more tender moments of my cancer journey. It's going to be dynamic storytelling. I'm very animated. I was like that child in school that would get in trouble for talking too much. But in this case, we are going to share some laughs. We're going to share some tears. But most importantly, we're going to leave filled with hope, because the very sheer fact that we are meeting and that we're having this fundraiser, we are rallying together, it is cause for hope. And knowing that we are in this fight together until we could see the day where we say, there's cancer no more. But that is what we're fighting for, and it's so very worth it. I want to see you. I want to see the people that come out.
I cannot wait. January 27th can't come soon enough. Chaunte Lowe, thank you so much for joining us today.